Hello everybody, welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am your host, Damon Pettit, and today I'm going to do a, holy cow. A beautiful double Ligero LDF. And it is a beauty, should be nice, it's the DL600. And the Flor Dominicana is have a pretty damn nice reputation. I'm trying to think if I've had any that I haven't really liked. As far as I know, there are none of those. I am doing this while doing the Meerkat thing too, but I'm going to concentrate on my review camera, and then if anybody joins in on the Meerkat and they actually say something, I'll let everybody know if there's a question or a remark or whatever. That way it's not, I don't think the way I was doing it before was really that great for my actual review. So let's get this baby cut. Should be a pretty strong cigar, or at least pack a bit of a punch, probably. Let's see how this works. Oops, I got the lock on. And I still got it on. There we go. Hope everybody's doing well today. The last review I did, I still have not put that one up, so I'm constantly behind. I gotta figure out what I'm doing. Not bad. Pretty strong. Going to pair it with a beer. This, I don't even know what the hell it is. Batch 19. Pre-prohibition style. Yeah, I'm sure. We'll see. I'm sure for the most part, it's all marketing. The bottle looks pretty cool, actually. I like that. I actually like that. I'm not a big beer guy anyway, but so I don't drink a ton of beer, and I wouldn't be able to review a beer or even recommend a beer, I don't think. I could tell people what I like, but as far as recommending a beer, that would never really happen for me, just because I don't drink enough of it. I never cared about it earlier in life, and now I just drink them every now and then. I'll get, like this time I got, actually went to the store, I bought, you know how you can go to the store and you buy single beer to make a six pack and it's like $9 or something like that. That's what I did. And I did that because I wanted to have a beer with my review today. It just sounded good, something, I don't know, kind of cold and everything. And I knew I was going to be right around, wasn't going to drive to my review, so I figured what the hell. And then opened the trunk, put a couple in my bag that I have the cigars in, and my other stuffs for the cigar reviews, and then shut the trunk. Right at that moment, I knew it. I had my keys in the trunk. So I was only, luckily, a couple miles away from home, and it wasn't too late. It's 10 o'clock, and my best friend, she came and she let me in the car. So that was nice. Nice to be let in. And I couldn't believe I did that. Get on with a cigar, huh? I've had a few different ones. This one has a Ecuadorian Sumatra. It's a sun-grown Ecuadorian Sumatra sun-grown wrapper, I believe. And the filler and the binder are Dominican. So, that's pretty. Makes for, so far, a very, very nice tasting cigar. You never know, you know. But this one, so far, is not bad. Just give a little... Wow, I actually like that beer. I don't know who makes it, even. I don't know, Batch 19 is who makes it. Oh, wait. Oh, no, let's see. Let's take a look, huh? Oh, my God. That's funny. Coors Brewery. Archives. That's fucking hilarious. I did not know. Inspired by an authentic recipe with Stristel Spalt and, are you shitting me? This has got to be a joke. Hershocker hops. Wow. The glasses are kind of broken. Not that I care that much. Those are reader glasses or whatever the hell you want to call them. For those who spend too much time looking at their phone or the computer, I guess. That's me. It is definitely, so far, a very, very decent cigar, very nice cigar. It's a beauty as far as the construction look. It's got a nice draw. It's not too hard of a draw, and again, but it's not too easy either, which makes a difference to me. I don't like really trying to move the microphone up a little bit just in case you could hear me. You can hear my beautiful voice. As you can see, it gets plenty of action with the smoke. Been around, I'm trying to think of the first Ford Dominicana. This is a long time ago, the one that I had. Like the very first one. Of course, this is the, again, the double Lajero. As you can see that right there. I really like the band on these. I like that it's just a nice, and it's pretty, I don't know what you want to call it, Jesus. There was a bug crawling down there and I did not want it crawling on me. It's just kind of a classy band. Very enjoyable. As far as seeing it and looking at it. I like the dressiness of bands and labels and stuff like that. I know that that's a big part of the marketing for different products like wine and stuff. You know, if you get somebody who knows absolutely nothing about wine you know, and they're going to go buy a bottle of wine. And they want to, you know, I think kind of, if they've really never had wine maybe at some place, somebody ordered it or whatever, I think if they, they'll kind of look at the, you know, oh, this one looks like it should be pretty good. The label's nice, look at that, you know. I think that that's a big part of it. I think we all know that. I think it has affected what I've bought before. This chair's a little bit. There we go. Not bad at all. It's been a busy week, very busy week for me. Been pretty busy. Every week goes fast as usual. And I bought this so that I could open the beer. And it's probably a twist top or something, I don't know it. But it's a dollar. I don't drink beer enough to where I have something at home, but I don't carry something with me, so. And I didn't go back inside my home before I came out here to smoke my cigar. I don't know if you, those of you who are looking for a different kind of activity, a fun activity, might want to, especially with your kids, these trampoline parks that they have. I think that they're called trampoline parks. I don't know. They're all named something different, but they're pretty cool. Pretty cool. That's really. I'm sorry, but even though Coors brews this shit, it's got a nice taste. Like I said, I'm not a beer purist in any form, so I don't know what real beer drinkers would think of it. I don't mind it. And you gotta remember, though, I like wine. I'm a wine guy more than anything. I drink a lot of wine. Usually when I'm picking something to drink, it's either wine or, you know, like a hard liquor. Then every now and then I get a hankering for some beer. So that's what today was the hankering day, I guess. Looks like I lit it a little bit funny, so it's burning a little bit lopsided, but that usually corrects itself at some point. Here in Arizona, for those of you never seen any of my little videos, and it's beautiful out here. It's about 75 probably right now right here. I'm in shorts and a t-shirt, pretty much usual. So, really can't complain about too much, I guess. I could think of some things to complain about, but really, why? Tell you what, the news, it's not something to watch. But when you do watch it, and you see the shit that there is, it's pretty incredible. The whole thing with a gentleman that was gunned down by that police officer in the back, too. I mean, come on, really? Gunning somebody down in the back, shooting at them 8 times. Now, first of all, shot at him, he wasn't, you know, weaving and bobbing. That guy took off and was running a pretty straight line, diagonal line. And that cop missed him 3 times. So if there would have been anybody in that area on that other side, there's three stray bullets. That's there, you know. So the guy, first of all, pretty shitty shot. And then he throws five slugs into that man's body, killing him. One of them did, I believe, go into his heart. I believe he probably died quite quickly. But then he goes up to him and handcuffs him as his face is in the ground. And then the cops, the ones that, you know, wrote that they tried to give him CPR or whatever, didn't happen. It's just unbelievable. Unbelievable to me. So, I think people need to always continue to break out their cameras when they start to see action occur. And hopefully, for the most part, you know, that kind of shit's not going to go down as much. It's going down like that all the time, obviously, but if it wasn't for the other gentleman that actually was brave enough to actually have that all recorded, I wouldn't be surprised if that guy would have got away with it, that cop, so-called cop, that ex-cop, who should now probably be a convict for quite some time. I don't know, it's very hard to see that kind of shit. So, see something here. Come on. Whatever. Anyway, get back with my review here. What was I say? Wish I didn't have to use glasses to read small shit. It'd be kind of nice. See if I can, I'm trying to naturally get my eyesight stronger and better. We'll see what happens with that, huh? About a year from now, I'll be blind. This cigar is not bad, though. Flor Dominicana. Once again, show that. Show it over here, too. For those of you in Meerkat world, I'm doing a cigar review. And so far, it's going good. So that was the shitty news that, obviously, I saw this week. I know that baseball is gotten started. I'm unfortunately not a big baseball guy. It's been a really long time since I've gone to a baseball game. A very long time. And so I really wish I was a baseball fan, because there are so many games. The season is so long. And the games aren't, you know, horrifically expensive, at least as far as I know. I think that they're, you know, especially if you sit in the shitty seats. And you can kind of, for a baseball game, unless it's like, you know, postseason stuff, you can kind of hang out and just chat and watch the game. Almost like you do at home when it's on TV. I might be wrong about that, you know, just because I've gone to very little, probably like 7 baseball games my entire life, probably. And none of them have been for any kind of stakes at all. is that standing there? Anyway. The cigar, expected it to be stronger, but right now, it's just very, very tasty. It's going great with this freaking beer that I got, too. Like I said, I didn't expect anything, because I'm not that big of a beer drinker either, but, you know, what the hell. Part of it is, I think, if I drank beer more, I would probably drink a lot of beer, and that would probably be a problem after a while. I'm slowly but surely trying to get all my older reviews on a certain thing. I'm making sure that I'm getting them on Vimeo, because YouTube is so gracious enough to completely mute your video if you happen to have a song in the background that has some sort of copyright on it. Now, I understand the whole copyright thing, you know, I don't believe in, you know, stealing somebody's shit and making money off of it or anything else, or even doing it to, for whatever, but, you know, it was in the background, it was just playing off of my Pandora thing, and, yeah, really, you know, to me, they should at least give you an opportunity to mess with your video so that that song's not in there or whatever, instead of just muting it and completely destroying the video. You know, it's not the end-all be-all, but kind of, if you have your videos and stuff, just always, you know, don't put them all in one thing. Oh, it's somebody's car, I think. Jesus. See, that burn definitely corrected itself, and it's burning really nicely now. I lit it weird, so that's probably why it was like that for a while. I'm at a pool area right now, and show the meerkat around, let them see the surroundings. And there's a cat that's over there that is actually drinking the pool water. Which is just kind of sad. I don't know how good. I don't like to swim in pool water because of whatever, you know? So I guess what you don't know isn't going to hurt you, right? And I guarantee you, that cat doesn't know. But I guess when you're thirsty, I know I've been hiking once where I got so thirsty that I would have pretty much, whatever liquid I would have seen, I would have had some, because it was, now, besides somebody else's urine, maybe, I would have still held out some hope, I think, probably, to bypass that and keep moving on. Oh, yeah. Not bad at all. Not bad. Nothing like a Sunday night. We can just hang out, relax, have a cigar. Think about your life. Think about the good stuff, the bad stuff. Try not to think about the bad stuff, though, because that's always, you know, there's always going to be bad shit happening every now and then. No reason to sit there and think about it all the time. Just work through it, move through it, and keep moving on. And get to the good shit. really nice out here today. It's quiet. I don't like that. Cigars got a lot of flavors, like nutty type flavors. Very light. Light flavors, but it's a stronger cigar. I don't know. I did expect it to be stronger, and so I'm not disappointed. I'm a little bit surprised that it's not like, ugh. But it's extremely flavorful. And I'm a... That ash didn't even want to fall off of there. I didn't knock it off. Pretty big fan of the sun grown wrappers. Sun grown wrapper, the Brazilian wrapper on a cigar seems to really give it some nice flavor. So all those are things I like quite a bit. This one is a Robusto size. So it's kind of a, usually a Robusto size to me, depending on how you smoke a cigar, is going to last you a good 45, 50 minutes to an hour maybe, depending on how you smoke it. It seems to be a little bit longer than an actual Robusto, like a, I don't know, cause it's here, was there, and so usually this is kind of the Robusto size, at least in my thing, my experiences. Oh my god. Sometimes just thinking about sleep is really nice. I have another beverage, but I don't think I'm going to end up having to open that one. It's one of those that are like, it's, I don't know. Honeycrisp apple wheat. So it's one of those beers that tastes like apple or something, I guess. We'll see. I don't think I'm going to end up drinking that. We'll see. I'll have that later on, maybe. Maybe I'll have it now, I don't know. I like beer with actual flavor. That's, I think, growing up, there weren't all these different kinds of beers. Like, there was just, you know, there was just Coors and Bud and Schlitz and all that bullshit. And, just all the Miller, trying to think of all the other ones that are out there. But, they all kind of had, you know, pretty much the same type flavors, the same, just, I don't know, didn't have a lot of nothing to it. Now we have all the microbreweries out, and some of them are very good, some of them are so good that, you know, a little microbrewery will be, you know, people from a completely different state way out there somewhere is looking for that beer or whatever, so it's pretty cool. So it kind of enhances the whole drinking a beer, at least for me. And that's why I'm a little bit surprised, because this one, you know, is mixed in with all these others, some of the microbreweries and all the different ones that are in there, and I was just picking ones out just kind of based on the ones that I've never had, and so this is one of them. And then I didn't look at anything as far as what kind or who makes it, so I was a little surprised to see that it's a Coors made beer, and my father back in the day worked there. He worked at Coors Brewery for 15 years. So, I don't know when he started. It had to have been, I know he was working there when I was a little, like, just a few years, 4 years old, maybe. And so I don't know, I don't remember when he said he started working there. It was 15 years. So it had to be about when I was born or something like that. And then they laid a bunch of people off. They apparently had some sort of problem back in the day, which that was a long time ago, maybe 84 or something like that. Don't know for sure, but you know, he worked there for 15 years. He knew people there that were there for like 20 some years, and that was back in the day when you would. You would work for a company, and then you'd retire, and you'd receive a pension from that company, you know. So, you know, he had 15 years in there. He's probably looking at, you know, obviously he would have ended up retiring from there, but anyway, he got laid off, was never called back, so he got a big severance package, but then, you know, they laid a ton of people off that were there, like, right, you know, people that were in their 50s, early 60s, that even got laid off, that were there for, like, 19 years, 20 years. Just totally fucked those people over. And, luckily my dad was young enough, because he had me, that he didn't actually give birth to me. I know that's a shocker. But, you know, my parents had me when they were, like, 20. I don't know how the fuck they did that. So, he was still young, and, got on with another company, and stayed there until retirement. Worked his way the hell up, and did real well. Now he's retired and still working, but he's retired. And but I know that I'm I don't have those things. I'm going to, you know, at 60 whatever, retire and have myself a little house, whatever. I'm just going. I just know I'll probably be working until I die. And the main thing is however I make money, I want to continue to always enjoy every day as much as possible. I know there's always a bad day at whatever job, whether you're making millions of dollars or minimum wage or whatever it is, you're always going to have a bad day sometime. I mean, maybe that's not true. I don't know, but more likely it is. And, so, I don't know. Apparently I'm talking so much that the, cigar is trying to go out now. It's burning a little funny, though. A little surprised about that. Bitch, don't do that shit. I've got my handy lighter. If you want to know where you get those lighters, let me know. Somebody let me know that they actually looked for it, found it, and sent me a link in a comment in one of my YouTube videos, and I don't remember person's handle or their name at off the top of my head. I barely remember my own name. So, I don't remember that person, but that person did that, and so I I kept that link, and I'm good to go. So if you want to know, let me know. They're very, not that expensive, and you can even do it. You know, I think I like $12 or something like that. But it's a great lighter. It really is. It's just, you know, it's obviously not one you want to carry around in your pocket. I had another, you know, one of those nice other little torch lighters, ones that you would put in your pocket, and of course I went to the airport with that in my pocket. They're like, you know, you can do this, you can do that, and I'm like, yeah, fuck it, just keep it. When I go to the airport, when I fly someplace, I don't do that all the time, but when I do, I like it to be drama-free, I like it to be hassle-free, I like to be able to get there somewhat early, go through the security, have them put their fingers in my ass. That's actually the fun part. Kidding. You know, get through the little security thing with no problems. Doesn't always happen. As far as, I always make it through security pretty much no problem, with the exception of that lighter. And so that's why I was just like, no, just keep it, just let me go. You can have the lighter, you can shove it up your ass, you can do whatever you want with it. Just keep it. Move on, please. And so they're like, okay, are you sure? I'm like, yes, I'm sure, just let me go. It's not like they weren't detaining me or anything. They were being very nice, but just didn't want to deal with it. If it would have been like a gift or something that really meant something to me, then I would have had to figure out something. I don't know what. This beer and this cigar go really good together. Really felt like a alcoholic beverage today with my cigar. Usually doing coffee or something like that. Tea. I really love black tea, you know. But anyway, today was a beer day. Good choice for me. Pat myself on the back for that one. I brought a little bit of a small candy bar, because I was going to maybe have a piece of chocolate just to see what that was going to be like. What the hell, huh? Let's do it. Let's do it. Listen, I don't, like, I try not to have too much sugar, too much, you know, sweet stuff or whatever, so I try to get the smallest ones I can. So that, you know, I have it around forever. It's a special dark. Oh, yeah. A little bit bigger piece than I thought. Let's see how that goes with my cigar. If anybody knows, I did something up in here. I don't know, maybe I have a tumor. I'm guessing that's not it. I hope it's not, but it always comes into your mind every now and then, you know. You see a special report of somebody. Yeah, I had this pain and found out it was cancer. I'm like, really? Pain? Anytime you get a little pain that you've never had, you're thinking, oh God, am I dying? I don't go to the doctor, so I don't know. So if anybody knows of anything like a bomb or a place to go or something like that, let me know. It's like, been going on for weeks now. And barely do that, so it's really starting to get on my nerves. Let's see how this works out here. I changed it. I changed the way that tastes. Pretty cool. So remember that, my friends. If you're eating and smoking a cigar, I'm sure, I know a lot of people, like, there are people out there that smoke probably multiple cigars a day. Some people probably smoke a cigar with their meal. I'm not one of those. My cigar time is usually time to hang out, relax, and just do whatever I want, whether it's crying or listening to music or drawing or reading. Used to spend a lot of my cigar time trying to write screenplays, and I started to see, you know, I knew that unless I met somebody that knows somebody, that is somebody, the odds of that any of my screenplays ever being bought or seen are so minimal that it became something where that dream kind of started to really get shoved into the garbage disposal and get ready to hit that switch, because it just, I don't know, it's irritating, because if you see the movies that are made now, you know, it's like, what the hell? I know that there are millions, if not more than that, screenplays that have been denied and not looked at, whatever. That it's, then they make movies that are, what they do, then they do a, like 21 Jump Street, they're making movies from TV shows, they're making movies, remaking movies from back in the day, and really, you can't use these people's incredible story ideas. I just saw a little thing for a new Arnold movie, and I don't know if it's gonna go straight into video or what it is, because a clip of it, you know, preview or whatever the hell, and I don't know if it's gonna be in the theaters or not, but it looks pretty interesting. It's not, you know, like a Terminator movie or whatever, and those are the kind of movies I think he should do. I mean, really, he can't act. People don't think that he can, really, or whatever, maybe, but he can. I mean, just look at the kind of human being that he really is, and then look at, like, his character in Twins, how he played this innocent, you know, virgin and all this other crap. You know, it's pretty believable. I think I'd like to see him in some good kind of roles of some sort like that. That bite of the candy bar made it taste differently. But it's still good. There's still a lot of flavors in the cigar going on. And it's not, you know, there's no, not getting any, like, coffee notes or anything like that. Still pretty much in wood, nuts, stuff like that. It's definitely getting a little bit more acidic as you, you know, get further into the cigar. But still has a definite, decent flavor going on. Definite worth it. It's definitely, and I don't know how much I paid for this bitch, probably about $7 maybe? Maybe a little less, I don't remember. It's always going to vary state to state. But, I would get the cigar for anybody that I know. Even for ones that don't smoke that many cigars, like maybe once a month or whatever. You know, if you know somebody like that and you're wanting to get them a cigar, probably not a bad idea to get one of these. Because it's not too strong, but it does have some strength to it, so it's not going to, like, punch them in the face and knock them out. It's just gonna, you know, they'll taste it, and they'll have the remnants of that taste for a while, but it's not going to be horrible. I'm trying to see if I can pick up any kind of different things, but nothing real different going on there. Not bad, though. I just wanted to thank everybody for tuning in to another review. And I hope everybody's doing well. Whenever you end up seeing this video, I hope you end up enjoying it and able to hang out, relax, and just, I mean, it's fucking 50 minutes long almost. 50, not 15. So it's a long one again. Most of mine are. But that's kind of what they're for. Sit back, hang out, and watch my shit, and decide what you like. But, I appreciate you watching. And, I'm going to get this one up. I'm going to end up probably posting last week's one today or tomorrow. And then this one I'll post in a couple days. And then, I'll be back on track with all that crap. So, and then a Meerkat, you know. The last two I've done I've used the actual Meerkat video. So it's, you know, I don't know, it was a little bit more, I kind of got confused the first couple because I was, I didn't know what I was doing, so. So anyway, hope everybody there is doing well, and thank you very much for watching. Feel free to comment, tell me how much you hate it, like it, whatever you want, and keep enjoying your day. I hope everybody just continues to love life as much as you can, and love the people around you, and try not to look at all the bullshit, you know, try to get some of the good stuff out there, you know, and have a good day. So, till then, I'll be smoking with you again soon. Take care.